Hello, my people. Hello, everyone. Welcome to lesson number 7 of our series, Statistics Made Easy. Today is April 30th, 2020. I want to take the opportunity to wish my elder brother, His Excellency Dr. Ebenezer Okebukola, many happy returns of today, today being his birthday. Last lesson number 6, we conducted another post-hoc analysis, and we looked at types of post-hoc analysis and how to report the results. Today, excellent, a wonderful day. We are going to learn how to conduct multi-way ANOVA. Oh, there's a question coming already. Why multi-way? Well, first things first, before I answer the question, I'm taking you back to lesson number 1, where we looked at variables, categorical variables, quantitative data. We had examples of for our class sex, location, and SES, socioeconomic status. So we're looking at categorical variables here. And we also partitioned all our variables in the study to quantitative and categorical, like this. Scores on discussion forum, attitude to science, and all of this. And sex, specialization, being categorical variables. Oh, somebody's asking a question again so soon. Can you, the teacher, please answer the question, what is a way, directly? Ah, my friend, take it easy now. I'm trying to give you the thing from the back because I expect that you remember this thing. It appears that all you learned the last time was a short-term memory. We call this a memory flow. Short-term memory will teach you, and the next day you forget, or even a few seconds, a few minutes after that, you forget. But when you rehearse, when you go back to the lessons, you will have the thing going into long-term memory. So you should trust me that I'm taking you from the past to the present. So question, why can't you trust an atom? This is because they make up everything. You know, I'm not making up anything. I'm just taking you back to lesson number 1. So to answer your question directly, the way, when you say one way, two way, multi-way, the way is the categorical variable or factor that you want to study or test with the ANOVA. So let's look at the list of categorical variables or factors in our present study. We have nationality, we have sex, we have SES, we have specialization, we have institution. You see, for the institution, I've changed it slightly to mean training method, to say that those in LASU ACC are trained using the CTCA approach, and those in University of Burundi Doctoral School using the lecture method. That's just by way of trying to get a variable called training method, a degree and location. So the number of ways is actually the number of factors that you are subjecting the ANOVA. So if you have nationality and sex, you are looking at 2 ways. I'll talk about them in a minute. So depending on this number is what you mean as what you take to be ways. So let's answer the question to the number of ways. One way will mean ANOVA on any one of the following factors or independent variables: nationality, sex, SES, specialization. If you take any one and run ANOVA on it, you are doing one way ANOVA. But if you take any two of these, then you are doing a two-way ANOVA. The thing is quite logical, though, one way, two way. So look at examples of two way ANOVA. If you are looking at a training method and sex on something or dependent variable, then it is two way ANOVA. Or training method and socioeconomic status is two way ANOVA. Or training method and location, two way ANOVA. Let's look at three way ANOVA. Three way ANOVA is where you take any three of these factors or independent variables. Look at this one. I'm just going to take this one. Institution, that's training method. Nationality and degree. You can see 1, 2, 3. That's a three-way ANOVA. What about 4? 4 is taking any 4. This is becoming like a primary school, elementary school thing now. It's quite understandable, I believe. So 4-way ANOVA is where you're taking any 4 of this, like institution 1, nationality 2, sex 3, and location 4. And a 7-way ANOVA is when you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 all being studied in terms of the impact of a dependent variable. That's 7-way ANOVA. The question somebody want to ask me is, how many ways can you have You can have as many ways as you have your factors or independent variables. So ANOVA, multi-way ANOVA is ANOVA on more than one of the following factors. Now this slide is very important, as I've put a stamp on it here. So these are the factors or categories in our own or independent variables in our study. The training method, which I've taken to be the institution, LASU ACC, being the CTCA group, University of Burundi, being the lecture group. So levels, 2. That's 1, 2. Nationality, 4. Sex, 1, 2. SES, average low, 3. Specialization, you see them here, STEM education, ICT education, the one we used in our last lesson, 6. Degree, first class, second class, 2. Location, rural, urban, 2. Oh, question again. I like this class because you're asking me questions. Teacher, yes, that's me. Tell us how we reflect the levels of the factors in the ANOVA design. That one is small thing, though. I can always talk about design, design, design. So in terms of design, the world is said to be like a cat in terms of design, playing with Australia. See, this Australia down under, you can see it like a cat playing under. That's design. But the design we're looking at now is the multi-way ANOVA design. So let's look at examples of two-way ANOVA. Two-way ANOVA will mean two factors. Any of these two factors. Now I'm taking training method, which are two levels, LASU ACC or the CTC approach, and the lecture method of University of Burundi. So two levels. And then sex, two levels. So it's what the design then is a 2x2 ANOVA design. Three-way ANOVA, as the name implies, you have to have three factors. Here we have training at two levels, sex at two levels, and SES at three levels. You can check them out here. So it's 2x2x3. Okay, let's look at a four-way ANOVA. Four-way ANOVA, four factors we are looking at is training, nationality, sex, and SES. 2x4x2x3 ANOVA. Well, nothing can be as simple as this. And so when you are describing the ANOVA, assume the factors selected are training, sex, and location. So you then report your data analysis that you are doing a 2x2x2 ANOVA was applied on the data to explore the main and interaction effects of training, sex, and location on your dependent variable. So what have we learned so far? We have learned that the number of ways are determined by the number of categories of dependent variables in the design. We have also exemplified that one variable will mean one way, two variables, two way, three variables, three way, and so on. Question again. Good class. What do you mean by main and interaction effect? Well, the main effect is the effect of one independent variable or factor on the dependent variable. Don't worry yet if it's it'll be confusing. You're going to get it as easy as possible in a minute. Now, it ignores the effects of any other independent variables. Now, let's take our factors. Let's assume that the factors are training method, sex, and location. So when you use this, the main effect will be the effect of these three, as if they were acting alone, as if it were a one-way ANOVA for this, and for this. So to use the terminology that is coming up on COVID-19 issues, it's like maintaining social distance. Train method will say, oh, no, my friend, just stay your way. Sex will say, okay, no, you stay your way. I want to maintain my position. Location will say, stay your way. I want to maintain my position. So that's the main effect. They are not combining at all. What about the interaction effects? You see, let me begin this by telling you that most times you have the one phenomenon interacting with the other, not standing alone. No man is an island or woman is an island and entirely on its own. So you have a medicine that you take that it will say, oh, don't drink alcohol with it because that alcohol will react with it. And if you look at literature on the drugs, say, okay, this one interacts with it, so don't avoid taking alcohol, avoid taking this. So the interaction effect is very, very important. You see, the kind of training that is given may be dependent on the gender or the sex, either male or female, in understanding the concepts. So there can be interaction. So we have what we call the two-way interaction in this our example. Training, interacting with sex. Training, interacting with location. And sex, interacting with location. And then you have a three-way interaction to say, okay, the training you are given, the understanding by the student is dependent on whether the student is male or female, or whether the student is in a rural area or urban area. So there's this kind of interaction. So let's move on. Now, which statistical tool should we use? A statistical tool for our class is IBM SPSS Statistics. And how do you get it? The tool? You get it from your school, purchase it online, or purchase it from anywhere else. But ensure, I keep underlining this, do not depend on others to analyze your multi-way ANOVA for you or any kind of analysis. Do it yourself, get your computer, get your tool, analytical tool, analysis tool, and do it yourself. Avoid these mercenaries. They just collect your money and do rubbish for you. They cook up your results and they mess up your integrity. And when they've given you the result, when you are defending it with your project supervisor or with an examination team for your defense, you will not be able to do that successfully because you are not the author of the analysis. So let's get on to research questions. Now, before getting on to our research questions that want to probe, let me take you back to our questionnaire. So this is a questionnaire that we use to collect data for the course we took, surname, first name. It's an online questionnaire, very good. So this is the institution. We passed out others in this analysis. We only took the LASSO ACTS and Lesser Opportunity Doctoral Score. Letting LASSO ACTS be the group that was treated with CTC approach, and this one the lecture. Specialization, you have them. These are the categories, the factors that we're talking about. So let's go on to the assessment of effects of COVID-19 on the educational system. The one we pick now is on the virus itself. Students will know more about viruses in their science class as a result of COVID-19. So we're asking you that gave us this data to either strongly agree or disagree, or strongly disagree. I will convert this to numeric. So in conducting the ANOVA, multi-way ANOVA on the data, we came up with two research questions, but one research question having some sub-research questions. So let's look at it. Number one, is there or will there be statistically significant, underscore this word, statistically significant, main effect of A, training, B, sex, and C, location, on students' understanding of viruses as a result of COVID-19. And then number two, are there statistically significant interaction effects of training, of sex, and location on students' understanding of viruses as a result of COVID-19? Two beautiful research questions. What about the hypothesis? We decided to say the hypothesis in a null form. That is, want to stay on the fence. We're saying that there will be no statistically significant main effect of training, of sex, and location, or students' understanding of viruses as a result of COVID-19. We're also saying, by way of the second null hypothesis, that there will be no statistically significant interaction effects on this other bit. So what are we waiting for? We have our data, we have SPSS. So let's get on with doing the three-way ANOVA. The steps are quite straightforward, as easy as ABC, by the way. So we go to analyze. You know, when we're doing the t-test, where to compare means, or when we ANOVA, but here we're doing multi-way ANOVA. So we go to general linear model. You can see univariate, multivariate, repeated measures. We are taking univariate because we are taking the performance of the students or our assessment on the understanding of viruses, students' understanding of viruses. So it's just one. And that's our B5 variable. So this is univariate. So you just go to analyze, general linear model, univariate, and then within the univariate dialog box, you select B5, students will know that, and then you take your, the fixed factors are the factors, those independent variables of those categories, training method, sex, and location, and you just hit okay, and you are good to go. So that's theory. Let's get into action. Action, here we go. So we go to analyze. These are our data, a surname, first name, nationality, institution, the training, specialization, and all of that. So we go to analyze. What's next? Class. Yes, you are correct. General linear models. Model. What's next? Univariate. You are correct. This is a very brilliant class. Statistics made easy. Univariate. So what then should I do here? What's our dependent variable? Our dependent variable again is B5. B5, where are you? The students will know about viruses. So you put this one here. And then, where are the fixed factors? You know, we're doing a three-way ANOVA. So three things, three factors, three variables must enter here. So what are the three variables? We have training, let's see now. Yeah, here. We have training, that will come here. We have sex, that will come here. And we have location, that will come here. Now, let me show you a few things here. The model, a full factorial, yes, let's take it. Contrast, don't bother about this one for now until we get to another analysis, another lesson. The plot, you want to plot training with sex, you can do this, but we're skipping that. Post-hoc, we'll do this when we are able to see some significant values. Options, okay, let's take on homogeneity test because, you know, we want to check whether we have made that assumption of homogeneity. And Levine's test is the one that will show up. We may also look at discrete statistics or effects of estimates of effect size. This is very important for meta-analysis, but that is a story for another day. So are we good to go? Yes, good to go. So we say, okay, I repeat, let me reset the whole thing so I can show you. The dependent variable is the thing, that's a B5. B5, yes, it's B5. Students, yeah, this one. Students will know more about viruses in their science class, you can see. The fixed factors, the training method, you come up here, there are three of them. One, sex. Two, location. Three, that's it. And then let's see what else. Let's look at options. We take homogeneity test and we say, okay, continue. And we say, okay, that's it. So here we go. It has given us the univariate analysis of variance. It has told us that training method, the CTC approach for LASSO, there are 21 students there. Lecture method, University of Burundi, we have, this is covering me now, okay, fine. It will go. Sex, let me see. Yeah. Lecture method, University of Burundi, that's 20. Sex, we have 34 male and 7 female. Ooh. Location, urban is 36, excuse me. And rural is 5. So this is Levine's test of equality of error variances. If this thing is significant, we are in deep trouble. But thank God, it is not significant. As you can see here, it's not significant. 0.387. So we will have to be happy because it's telling us that the variances among our groups is homogeneous. So this is quite nice. So let's move on. Let's look at now the tests. Start looking at from here, training. That's the main effect due to training. Let's see. Oh, 0.4. Oh, this is much above 0.05. So this is not significant. That means we don't have significant effect, main effect on training. Let's look at sex here, 4 point something. Oh, 0.03, yeah, this is less than 0.05. So this is significant. This location, let's look at location 6.44, 0.16, oh, this is also significant. Meaning that we have training is not significant, main effect, location is significant, and sex is significant. So that's just it. So action by way of demonstration is over, but I like to tell you that there are several other interesting statistics that you can take out from that analysis. But this particular lesson is not going to all of those details. As we go on to some higher levels of analysis, we'll begin to explore the information that SPSS, IBM SPSS can give to us. Now let's conclude step 4 of 5. How do you present our 3-way ANOVA tables? This is it. You put a target table 1, you meta analysis and between subject that, so you have it. 21 for this, 20, that's the end. And then you look at this. The main effects are the ones here, training, sets, and location. These are the main effects. And these are the interaction effects. As I said, you take the one by one. Training and sex, training and location, sex and location. Recall the other diagram that we used. That is this diagram, interaction effects. Two-way interactions, training and sex, training and location, sex and location. And the three-way interaction, training, sex, and location. Yeah, as you can see now, training and sex, training and location, sex and location, training, sex, and location. You can see all of them, all the interaction effects fail to attain significance. So how do you report, that's step 5, how then do you report your findings? I normally find this quite nice, quite exciting. So this is the table that we saw. So you just see that the results show that the main effect due to training was not significant. And then you put this summary. You don't go ahead to say F calculated is 0.721 because this F calculated is less than the table value. Therefore, the F test is not significant. That's old way of rendering it. The correct way, the modern way of rendering it is this. F, you put in bracket the degrees of freedom between and within, or the error. See them? F1, that's 20. 36 is 0.1. This was 36. It's equal to 0.72. You can see 0.72 because we're taking to two decimal places. You take off this one. P greater than 0.05 because this is greater than 0.05. However, the main effects due to sex, look at sex. It's 1 degree of freedom, 136. Is equal to 4.737, which you can make 4.74, two decimal places. P less than 0.05. And location F136, that's 1 degree of freedom, 136, is equal to 6.44. See, 6.44, P less than, were found to be significant, and none of the interaction effects attain statistical significance. That's the end of story. That's what you're going to write in your project report, thesis, dissertation, or article for publication. So what are the decisions on the null hypothesis? Null hypothesis HO1, there will be no statistically significant main effect of A, training, B, sex, and C, location on students' understanding of viruses as a result of COVID-19. The decision is this. HO1A, that's this one on training, is not rejected since we did not find a significant main effect of training. Correct? Correct. Null hypothesis 1B and 1C are both rejected since significant main effects were found for sex and location. You note that in hypothesis testing, taking a decision, it is not accept or reject or not accept. It is not rejected or rejected. Accept is not part of this dictionary in decisions regarding null hypothesis. So let's look at the second one. HO2, there'll be no statistically significant interaction effects of A, training, sex, and location of students' understanding of viruses as a result of. You will recall that we didn't find anything. We didn't find any statistically significant interaction effect So even without reading this decision, it means that this hypothesis is good. So we do not reject it. So decision HO2 A, B, and C were not rejected since we did not find significant two or three-way interaction effects between and among training, sex, and location. So to sum up, in this lesson, we learn how to conduct and report multi-way ANOVA. End of story of multi-way ANOVA. But watch out, don't pass one way because the wrong way. Next lesson, we will learn how to conduct analysis of covariance. I tell you, this one, lesson 8, this analysis of covariance is very sweet. I really, really love it. So until next time, I'm Peter Okebukola. My email ID is this. Feel free to get in touch with me. It is bye for now.